But Oedipus died. Oedipus' sons died. Creon's moment had come. He took over the kingdom.
Ha! I'll tell you something about Creon. He has a tendency to fool himself. This leader of men, this brilliant debater and logician, likes to believe that if it were not for his sense of responsibility, he would step right down from the throne and go back to collecting manuscripts. But the fact is, he loves being king. He's an artist who has always believed that he could govern just as well as any man of action could. And he's quite sure that no god nor any man can tell him anything about what is best for the common people.